Welcome to a new week on the group chat, everybody. I think one of the worst things in football is losing a semi-final. But the thing about it is there's really not much time to dwell on it. Two huge, huge games for the club coming up this week. The lads are here to reflect on it all. Danny, Wes, Ben and Maisie's decided to put in an appearance as well. Boys, everything okay? All good?
All good, Jake. All good.
All good. Thanks, mate.
Weather a game with Ben. It's outrageous, isn't it? It's outrageous. It's always how'd you do it, mate? How'd you do it?
I've been background now. It's got to be a background.
It is the first time it's been like this in July.
Right. We're jealous.
It's not been great, honestly.
Wes, I'm going to start off. I've got a question for you that Tommy has emailed in. So I'm going to start with a question for you, Wes. This is quite specific, so I don't know if you can remember this. But in 2003, when I was 13, I played for my school in the Manchester Cup final against Oakwood School. It was at Parswood Fields, and we won 2-1. After the game, my teacher told me Wes Brown had been watching the game, as he was watching his nephew, who was playing for Oakwood. I never saw him. I was busy setting up the winner, and I've been wondering recently if this was actually true. Did Wes have a relative playing for Oakwood that day, and was he actually there, says Tommy.
I had someone that went to Oakwood, yes.
So you were probably there?
Yeah.
There you go, Tommy. We've answered the question for you. We've answered the question, simple as that. MUTV@manunited.co.uk if you ever want to get in touch with this show. Right, boys, we've got to talk about Wembley. First of all, Ben, you were there. Was it as grisly as it appeared?
Yeah, unfortunately, it's from all the adulation that we've given the team, certainly since the restart, but even going back before the lockdown, it was a really disappointing performance. I don't think anybody really, you could say, stood out for Manchester United. And what was made it doubly disappointing was that Chelsea weren't all that great either. But what they did do with the ball, and obviously the mistakes that Manchester United made, gave them a well-deserved victory. And yeah, it was just a really disappointing day. Nothing clicked, nothing gelled. And we didn't really create anything either, apart from obviously the penalty that Bruno converted. And that's all we had to show for 90 minutes work, really. And yeah, an incredibly disappointing day. A great chance to have gotten to the final. And let's have it right, with Manchester City out of the way, a great chance to win a trophy.
Anybody see this coming?
No.
Not
in that way, yeah. I think I've just stole Danny's thunder there. Not in that way, Stu. I just thought we was careless with the ball, gave it away too. Sometimes you don't mind giving the ball away in the right areas, you know, when you're trying to create something, but needlessly, the way we gave it away was really poor. And probably that's our worst performance since lockdown and probably since the run started. And it's a shame that it's happened at such an important time in the season, Stu, for a semi-final. But I think we could have played all day, to be fair, and never have got close to them. It was one of those games. And, you've got to dust yourself down now because, as you said, Stu, two massive games. You've got to make sure that, you turn up and you do the business, certainly for Wednesday. Sunday, you can monitor that and you can do that. But first and foremost, you've got to beat West Ham.
Yeah, Dan?
Yeah, I just think it was uncharacteristic of, like, the mistakes we were making were really basic mistakes. And then, 10-yard passes, I think a big thing was not stopping crosses. The crosses were just coming into the box all day. And I think, you look at how good Wan-Bissaka's been, how good Brandon Williams has been since he's been in the team. They'd normally be getting closer and stopping. And you're only talking a matter of a couple of yards. But Chelsea love to cross the ball. As Piliquetta gets up and crosses the ball, the Reece James gets down the outside. They were doing the same with Alonso. And I think we could just feel it coming. Obviously, they scored their first goal through Giroud off a cross. And you could just feel it coming. If you keep giving them the opportunity, they've got good quality on the ball. Eventually, they'll hit the mark. And they did it at a time where, just before half time, it was a bit of a killer blow to us. So, yeah, we needed to dig deep and we just couldn't find it yesterday.
Yeah, were you surprised by what you saw?
Yeah, it was. It was very sloppy at times, very slow. Chelsea were sort of pressing us high and everything was really slow and they were getting to us, making us make mistakes. And it's just something that we've not seen for a while from us and, lack of concentration as well. We weren't really in our flow. We didn't get many chances. you know, we just sort of let them sort of press high and dictate, really. So it's a shame because we've been playing really well. And I know we changed formation a little bit. We changed some players. But, you know, you just need to get the mistakes out of the game, because in semi-finals, such as the FA Cup, you know, mistakes get punished, and that's basically what happened. And, you know, we only had a couple of opportunities. We scored one, and Marcus, we won. But other than that, we didn't really get a rhythm.
Well, you mentioned a formation, and we better discuss the team selection and formation, guys. I mean, bear in mind we played Monday, Thursday, and then Sunday. Was it not just inevitable that you had to make some changes? And that's what Ollie did. Pogba, Martial, Mason were rested or on the bench, and we had a change of shape. I mean, I thought it was trying to, he's trying to do two things, really. I get through in the cup and also look ahead to Wednesday and the weekend, which are massive for the club. It's difficult for a manager because you can't pick the same team all the time, can you, if you're playing Monday, Thursday and Sunday?
Why not?
Because of just simply because of fatigue, really, after an incredible spell of fixtures post-lockdown.
I think leaving those three players out would have given Chelsea a huge boost, I think. Because those three players have been frightening, to be fair, since they've come back. You know, Mason's banging goals in. Martial is on form, got us a penalty. And Pogba's been a different class as well. And I think I much would have rather changed the game for Wednesday than I would have done for the Chelsea game. But, you know, that's why Ollie's a manager. You know, you have to stand by his decisions. But I just thought leaving those three players out, on the flip side, if you're playing against Chelsea, or you're playing against Manchester United, you wouldn't want those three players playing against you. And I think that possibly was where we come unstuck, because later on in the game, as the game was, you know, we got the penalty. But I just think with those three in the game, we did start slowly but surely getting back into it. But obviously, you know, the three goals killed us.
The thing is, that shape has worked well in a couple of wins against Chelsea this season. So did you have a problem with the shape, or was it the personnel?
No, because as you said, you know, we've gone to Chelsea and played three at the back, five at the back, and we've got results. And I just thought that the way we were playing before that, rather than change to, you know, change the formation, I thought we had just stayed the same as what we've been playing, and Pogba and Matic and Bruno in there, and those two out wide. I thought it had been nailed on to have kept the same team, but obviously, you know, Ollie's decided to change it.
Guys, what do you think of that?
Yeah, I think we, like Maisie said, the change of formation and personnel, really, we just couldn't get started. There was no rhythm. Like, we've always had a rhythm, like with Mason and Martial, Rashin and the three in the middle playing together. And obviously, with so many changes, it just didn't get started at all. And it's a shame because it was an opportunity to get into the final, like Ben said, and win a trophy. But, you know, Ollie has to change the team at some point, and you sort of need the other lads to come in and sort of step up, really. But it just wasn't to be yesterday. And, you know, we couldn't get our rhythm going. And like you said, the goals were very sloppy and at very bad times as well. You know, just after half time, we come out and they score again. That it's hard to get up from that, you know, first minute of the second half. So, I mean, it didn't quite work. And, you know, the lads have been playing brilliant, but it has to change at some point. Different personnel have to come in and step up as well.
Yeah, I mean, guys, it's unfortunate saying this when we're talking about an FA Cup semi-final, but isn't the fact that Wednesday, unfortunately, is more important, because the Champions League is so important to the club financially and everything else, attracting players, whatever. But actually, Wednesday is more important. I don't like to say it because I love the FA Cup and I love the semi-final, but isn't it just the fact that Wednesday and next week, next Sunday, is more important?
I think they're all important. I think when a club of this size, all of it's important. You know, you want to win trophies and you want to be in the Champions League for next season. And I know you can look back and say it's progress, and it is. We've made huge, huge strides under Ollie. without a shadow of a doubt. But I don't think we're ever in a position where we can pick and choose which competitions we want to win and we don't want to win. I don't think Ollie's doing that. I think we want to win all of them. He just tried to change the team, get through. Bearing in mind, Fred was exceptional earlier on the season at Chelsea. So he's changed it thinking, well, Fred's done well against Chelsea before. And so in doing that, and Dan James obviously scored on the first game of the season against Chelsea. He was a problem to them. So he's probably thinking, well, they've done well against Chelsea before. He'll do well. But I think upsetting that front five, in effect, Bruno, Pogba in the front three, has just upset the rhythm a little bit. And Marcus looked a little bit frustrated throughout the game. He looked like he wasn't getting the ball at times where he normally would. So he stopped making runs. And you can, as a forward, you sense that frustration. But you've got a squad for a reason. But I think it just demonstrated that we do need to add one or two just to give the squad a boost again.
Yeah, Ben, would you go with that? The fact that obviously the first 11, so to speak, is exceptionally strong as we've seen, but the squad maybe just needs to be strengthened in terms of the depth of quality.
Yeah, I think so. I don't think that's behind the door for anybody who's been watching Manchester United. That the way that they have been performing with, let's say, the team that went unchanged for those four or five games, I think that what you want to be doing is making sure that you've got the right sort of quality to be able to have the depth and be able to change the team like Ollie did and understandably not worry about the opposition, because you know that you have got that quality. And his problem is going to be, who to select, because the squad is that great. But talking about West Ham on Wednesday, I'm with Maisie. I would have just played, my strongest team that he thought and that had served so well. The change of system shouldn't have been an issue. We just didn't utilise it properly. We had pace on either flanks. And whenever you're playing against a team, whether you're playing with wing-backs or not, the space is always in behind the wing-back, between the back and the centre-half. And we had Dan James on one side and Marcus on the other. And we just couldn't get out of our own half. And sometimes it's not a problem just to try and launch it, just to relieve a little bit of pressure. But we were playing 5-yard passes from David De Gea to Eric Bailly. And they were just, and because the lads have already said, our passing wasn't great. We give it away a lot. And within four or five passes, we turned possession over and we were still only midway inside our own half. I don't think the fullbacks pushed on anywhere near enough to try and be wing-backs. I think they were just content with being a five rather than a three. And it just, as Wes had said, we just never got going. We couldn't pass the ball. We couldn't get it forward. And it was just a frustrating game all round. But I agree that the Champions League is probably the priority for the club. And we're in a fortunate position that we've got two games left now. And all right, we beat West Ham on Wednesday. If we beat West Ham on Wednesday, which I'm sure we should do, I'm hoping that the mentality is that we've got to go and beat Leicester as well, because playing for a draw, which is all we would need if we beat West Ham on Wednesday, is a dangerous game to play. And obviously we know that even though Leicester have had a couple of dodgy results, they are also very, very capable with the likes of Vardy up there to be able to punish us. So yeah, I would say that probably, well, it is a priority now anyway, but before the game yesterday, I would still like to have seen like the team that has done so well under Ollie for those four or five games that we went unbeaten and unchanged.
What about the situation with David as well? The Ollie in his press conference after the game saying that David knows that he should have saved the second one. Simple as that. And obviously he knows that, but it is an unfortunate situation for David, who for so long has been so reliable. And it's just unfortunate in a game of that magnitude that particularly that second goal was there for everyone to see. What do you reckon, Wes?
Yeah, he'd be devastated with it. He should have saved it, and he knows that. And that's just concentration levels, Stu. The importance of the game as well. We can't be letting that sort of goal go in. Because it just kills David, but obviously it kills the whole team. Because especially the timing of it as well. You need to save that as normal, and we can still get back in the game. But even at 2-0, we just need to score the next goal, and we didn't. So it was a frustrating game all over, you know. And like we said, the passing wasn't crisp. We didn't speed it up straight away. You know, we started speeding up a little bit in the second half, but we sort of, you know, played into their hands a little bit in the sense that, you know, they were tracking the ball very high. They wanted the ball. They were trying to make us make mistakes, and we didn't sort of change the game. Like, we tried to still play the same. We should have turned them a little bit more and, you know, got them back on the back foot. But we just didn't quite do it. It just wasn't quite there. There was no real rhythm, and it's a shame. You know, and maybe a little bit was down to changing the formation a little bit and the personnel there. But, you know, the lads that come in have to understand that, you know, it doesn't matter who's on the pitch, we all have to sort of put the same effort in and the same qualities.
Has that performance almost made the manager's mind up, do you think, in terms of selection on Wednesday now? The sort of 11 that we've basically been seeing during this run, do you think that is essentially going to come straight back on Wednesday at Old Trafford?
I hope so. I hope he reverts back to 4-4-2 and, or, you know, the way we were playing with Paul in there, with Matic in there, Bruno, and the three lads up front. I hope he reverts back to that, because that is our strongest team, Stu. And, you know, you can go on about tiredness and fatigue and stuff like that, but you're playing in the semi-final of an FA Cup, Stu. And maybe I don't like saying it as an excuse, but, you know, that would have an effect. But, you know, you do get sloppy. And as Wes said there, the second goal killed you, because you just come out after half time. You'll have set your, you know, Ollie, you've set plans how to change and, you know, how do we go on from there? And within 5 minutes of the restart, you know, you're 2-0 down and you're like, Jesus, that's killed us. But you have to win on Wednesday, regardless. Whatever happens now, we have to win Wednesday. Because if you don't win Wednesday, Leicester's going to be tough. You know that. You know, they can sit and have a draw themselves if we don't win on Wednesday. They can just go out and beat us and, you know, we lose out on that.
We just need two big performances now, Stu. Two big performances. Like we said, the team that's been starting the last five league home games, that looks the strongest, and hopefully they're all fit and ready to play, but we need them to step up. Now, two games left and you've got to put everything into it.
Yeah, I mean, we would have definitely signed for this, wouldn't we, at the start of this run. It looked as though the top four was a big ask, and we were miles behind Leicester, 14 points behind Leicester, I think, at the end of January. So, for this situation where it is in our own hands, you've got two games left, you've got West Ham, you've got Leicester. Really, I know we're all disappointed because of yesterday, but you would have absolutely grasped this with both hands, wouldn't you, if you had offered this situation, Dan?
Yeah, no, I think you definitely would. And that's, you know, that's just because we're disappointed in this moment. It's not to take away what the lads have done over 18 games, because they've been exceptional at times. Some of the football we've seen, we've been on the edge of our seat, and I don't think there's been any people championing it more than us lot. We've been buzzing with it, but it's just disappointing because you know at the killer moment where you know we got beat last week and or we didn't manage to get in the, you know, right above into the third spot when we had the opportunity, and then you've got the cup final, the opportunity of the cup final, and we just miss out. That's just a frustration because you're on the cusp of, you know, breaking through, if you get what I mean. But there's two games to go. We've still got a trophy that we can win in the Europa League, so we can still finish the season in real positive fashion. But we've got I think Wes has said it there, you know, we've got to focus and concentrate on the next two games. And then you can play with the team a little bit in the Europa League. You've got last coming up. You know, we've already got the advantage there. And then if, you know, when we go through all being well, then you know, you can play with the team a little bit there and give the lads lads that have played a lot of football a bit of a break. So I just think the focus is now securing Champions League football, but then we can still win a trophy.
Yeah, and following on from what Danny says, I think they can, you know, they've got to now put the disappointment of yesterday behind them. Two huge games coming up, and what a massive difference that squad will feel in the dressing room, in the, you know, at the King Power Stadium next Sunday night, that we know that we've secured either third or fourth spot in the Europa League. and that'll give us the opportunity then to kick on, knowing that we're already in the Champions League, but to play with that little bit more freedom, knowing that we've got another trophy to play for. And you never know that we might have done it two times over, because I think that the way the team, barring yesterday, have performed, I still don't think there's anybody in Europe who is going to want to face us the way that we have played. And we've got what, I don't know, as Danny said there, is an opportunity against LASK, no matter what team that Ole Gunnar Solskjaer decides to pick, that deficit will never be overturned. And then he can concentrate again on the latter stages of the trophy and making sure that he picks his strongest team all the way to hopefully the final and winning it.
Yeah, I mean, it's easy for someone like me to say we've got to regroup quickly for Wednesday's game. But you guys know what it's like. You'll know what the player's feeling like after a heavy loss on Sunday. Is it easy to put it out of your mind and regroup quickly? Or is there going to be a bit of a hangover of some description today, at least, at Carrington?
This is where your characters come out, Stu, in the squad. You know, Harry Maguire's got to rally the troops. He's a captain. You're looking at him, you're looking at Pogba, you know, to rally the troops. Over the years, we've had great captains, great leaders, great warriors in there who will get the, you know, get the team at it. And that's what you've got to do. You've got to, you know, come Wednesday, 8 o'clock, whatever time kickoff is, we've got to be bang on the money and make sure we get that result. Because, you know, if you don't get it Wednesday, you know Sunday's going to be very, very tough. So Wednesday's imperative.
Yeah, it's 6 o'clock, just in case you're wondering. 8 o'clock, we'll be walking off.
Actually. Well, it'll be 8 o'clock somewhere in the world.
Yeah, that's true. I mean, what about West Ham then, boys? West Ham are safe. Does that make a difference to this one? Or David Moyes, will he come back and always have a little edge when he comes back to Old Trafford thinking, I want to show you something?
I think we touched on it last week, Stu. Everybody who plays Man United is up for the game. You know, whether there's something to play for or nothing, they always want to beat Man United. So, you know, we've always got to have that in mind when you're walking out onto the football pitch, and it's going to be a tough game no matter what. So we've just got to do what we do, get in the zone and just go at it and make sure we're relentless with our attitude.
Yeah,
well, I think there'll be a few nerves as well.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Do honestly. I think there'll be a few nerves. These lads will know that they turned in a very indifferent performance to what we're used to seeing yesterday. And, you know, as Danny said, there's no easy games in the Premier League. So it's not a case of, oh, we'll beat West Ham and then we'll concentrate on Leicester. We need to concentrate on beating West Ham, because that won't be easy. And I think the nerves will come into that as well, because the lads will know what a precarious position that they are in, even though a strong one.
You go with that, boy? Do you reckon nerves will be a factor at Old Trafford? Where's on Wednesday?
Well, they will be a little bit, but the main thing's a character, like Maisie said. You know, you've got to learn to just suck it up and get rid of it, and understand how important the next game is. And, you know, that's how you in championships, that's how you in cups. You know, every good team gets beat at some point, but it's how they come back from it, and that's what we've got to do.
Yeah. So what's going to happen Wednesday, boys? Are you going for a nervous evening, a tense evening,
5-0.
Or a regulation win?
Frustration win.
Really?
Yeah. Scrape it over the line.
And Liverpool to beat Chelsea after it.
Yeah, that's a good point, actually. So Chelsea aren't certainties for the top four, but Liverpool, Chelsea. But yeah, fingers crossed. Dan, you going for a win of sorts?
Yeah. For a win, yeah. I think when you're a wounded animal, you know, we've got to come out like that and fight. So I think, yeah, we should get the win, but it's not going to be easy.
Yeah, and the same and it's the same team that has been playing of late. You'd go for, lads, as well, roughly the same 11.
Yeah,
without Luke Shaw, I would have thought, but yeah.
Yeah, yeah. Fingers crossed. Big night for the club. Wednesday night at Old Trafford, 6 p.m. kickoff against already relegated West Ham, and we'll be back on Thursday morning to reflect on that. Hopefully, we're reflecting on victory and looking ahead to what could be a huge game at Leicester on the final day. Thanks for that, boys. We'll see you again on Thursday. Take care.
Cheers.